And among the traits of this only one single creator, which is Al-Ahad, Al-Wahid Al-Ahad, Al-Fardu Al-Samad, is he is the knower of the unseen, Al-Ghaib. And Al-Ghaib is either an absolute Ghaib, absolute unseen to everyone, no one have an access to it whatsoever, not even the prophets, not even the angels, no one whatsoever have an access to know it, but only him, the Almighty. And there is a partial Ghaib, such as you guys can see me right now and I have no access to see you. To me, you are Ghaib, but I am to you, you are am I being witnessed? Yes, I'm being witnessed. You can see me, but I cannot see you. So you're Ghaib to me, but I'm not Ghaib to you. Many, many cases like that. Among what Allah the Almighty have preserved for him as the knowledge of the unseen, which no one have an access to it, number one, the knowledge of the Sa'a. When will it take place? By the end of Surah Luqman, Allah the Almighty says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ. Allah has a knowledge of the hour, the day of judgment. When will it take place? Not even Prophet Muhammad, not even Angel Gabriel, peace be upon him, have any idea about it. Nowadays, through the ultrasound, we can find out whether the sister is pregnant or not. And furthermore, we can determine the gender of the baby, of the fetus, at an early stage. But who had clue before she was married that she will conceive and she would have a boy or a girl, or even twins or triplet? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have no idea about it. So he reveals to us some of the absolute unseen, so it becomes seen to some